Welcome to the lecture series on microcontroller programming. In today's lecture, we will start with the instruction set of 8051. That is, we are going to discuss what are the various instructions that we can write for 8051 in order to make the 8051 to perform very small operations. And when we write number of instructions in a sequence, it becomes a program. And when that program is executed by 8051, it performs a task. Okay. So before going to give tasks for 8051, first we'll write small instructions. And each individual instruction, when executed by the microcontroller, it performs a small operation. So the operation here means it can be anything which manipulates the data or which changes the data given. So for example, if I see that there are certain categories of operations that are performed by your 8051 microcontroller, some of them are for example, you can say that the arithmetic operations, logical operations, etc. So, for example, arithmetic operation, addition operation, subtraction operation, division operation, multiplication, complement operation. So, these are the essential operation that is performed by your 8051 microcontroller. For example, we can write instruction for the addition operation. So when that instruction is executed by the controller, it performs the addition on the given data. And you already know that instruction itself contains two parts. The first part is called opcode. The second part is called operand, where the first part of the instruction tells the type of operation to be performed, and the second part of the instruction tells or specifies the controller the data on which the particular operation is to be performed. So here in this unit 3, we are going to discuss a number of instructions which the 8051 is designed to execute, or which the 8051 understands and executes those instructions. So here the word execute has a rough meaning of reading the instruction by 8051 and understanding the instruction and performing some operation and giving out the results. This is called the execution of the instruction. And all this execution is performed by 8051 instructions. So this will go through the topics of this particular lecture. So here we'll explain the function of data transfer instructions. So here we have already classified the total instruction set of 8051, that is all the instructions of 8051, into 6 categories in the previous lecture, where the first category of instructions are data transfer instructions. So here we look at the first topic will be what is the function of the data transfer instructions in general and how they are affecting the flags. So we have already seen that the flag is a bit which indicates the status of the arithmetic operation. Okay, so that we have seen, and all these flags are present in a register called program status word, or PSW, that we have seen in the previous lecture. So also we look at the first set of instructions in detail. That is, explain the data transfer instructions with examples. And we'll also write a small program that illustrates the application of the data transfer or data copy instructions. So we'll use the already learned the learned data transfer instruction to write very small programs. So this is these are the three topics that we are going to discuss in today's lecture. So we'll start with the data transfer instructions and what is the function. So what are data transfer instructions in general will do. So a data transfer instruction, the name itself tells that the data is transferred, but it is not exactly the data transfer. So data transfer usually means transferring of the data from one location to another location. So from where you are transferring, that is called source location, and to where you are transferring, that is called destination location in general. So here, if you may understand that data transfer instructions will transfer the data from source location to destination location, but it is not exactly the transfer of the data, but it is copying of the data. Copying of the data from source location to the destination location. So what is the difference between the copy and transfer? So transfer means the data is transferred from source to destination. So after the transfer operation, the source is left with nothing, and whatever the data that was there at source is moved to destination location. That is what we mean by transfer. So transfer means the source location is left with nothing. Okay, and whatever there is, was there at source is moved to destination location. But this is not the actual operation performed by data transfer instruction. Though the name tells that it is data transfer, but the function performed is copying of the data from source location to destination location. So how copying is different from transfer now? So copying means the data is copied from source location to destination location, and after the copy operation, the source location has its original data that was there previous to copy operation. So copy operation kante mundu edaithe data undo that will be there at source location, and the data at source location will be copied to destination location. That means data at source and destination will be both same after the copy operation, and source has data even after the copy operation. So this is what you need to be careful with the data transfer instruction, right? So data transfer instructions copies the data from source location to destination location. The source content remains unchanged. The source content remains unchanged. So we are saying that the data is copied from one location called source to another location called destination. So what can be the source locations and what can be the destination locations in 8051? That is, in 8051, from one place to other place, or from one location to other location within that chip 8051 only, the data is copied. So from where to where we can copy? So we have seen that in 8051 we have a lot of registers, lot of memory locations. So can we transfer, can we copy the data from memory location to memory location, or from register to register, or register to memory location? So what are the possible data transfers that we can achieve by data transfer in this, in these instructions? Is we can, the first is we can transfer or copy the data from accumulator to any of the 8-bit registers, or vice versa. That means the data can also be copied from any of the 8-bit registers to accumulator. So here it is a double arrow. That means the transfer of data can be in either way, accumulator to 8-bit registers or 8-bit registers to accumulator. And the next data transfer can be between registers and an internal memory location. So there we have said that has internal memory. So internal RAM is there, internal ROM is there. So between any internal memory location and registers, we can copy the data. That is from register to internal memory location, or from internal memory location to any of the registers. And also, you can also see that this is also either way. And third type of data transfer instructions will copy the data, that is copy the data into registers. So copy the data into any of the registers. So directly we are giving the immediate data, and that immediate data means data is given in the instruction itself. So this immediate data will be copied to any of the registers. So this is one type of data transfer instruction. So the immediate data can be either copied to any of the registers, or the immediate data can be copied to any of the internal memory location. So this is only one way, because this is not a storage location. Immediate data is the data, but it is not a place where the data can be stored. It is not a place. So it's a data. So data can be copied to registers, or can be copied to internal memory location. So we have number of instructions that perform this function, and we have one more function performed, that is, so data can be copied from accumulator to external memory location, or the data can be copied from external memory location to accumulator. So that is, so when you want to add external memory for the 8051, you can copy the whatever the data that is present in external memory location to accumulator also, or accumulator, from accumulator you can copy the data to external memory location. And we have number of instructions that will come under data transfer, which will perform function. And you can also copy the data between any two internal memory locations also. So you can see that there are different set of data copy instructions which can copy the data either between accumulator to 8-bit registers, or 8-bit registers to accumulator, or registers to internal memory, or internal memory location to registers, or you can copy the data into either registers or internal memory location, or you can copy the data from accumulator to external memory location, or from external memory location to accumulator, or you can copy the data from one internal memory location to the other. So these are the various functions that are performed by the data transfer instructions of 8051. And you can see that when the data transfer instructions are executed, no flags are affected. So we have seen that there are how many flags? Carry, auxiliary carry, parity, overflow. So none of these flags are affected during the execution of data transfer instructions. So next we'll look at the each individual run transfer instruction and what is the function performed by each of those instructions. So before going to the individual run transfer instructions, we will categorize and we will divide all the data transfer instructions into three groups. So one first set of instructions will come under the category of move instructions. Move instructions. So the various mnemonics that we will use for move instructions are MOV for simple move and MOVX to move the data between controller and external data memory. External data memory. And MOVC is the mnemonic that is used to copy the data between 8051 and program memory. External program. So the general syntax or the general format of the move instruction will be, so first it will be opcode, whether it is MOV or MOVX or MOVC, and after that space the destination comma source. So that means when this instruction is executed, what happens is whatever the data that is there at source location will be copied to the destination location. So a number of instructions will fall into this category, and that we will discuss in detail. And second category is the stack instructions. So we have two instructions under the stack with the mnemonic push and pop. So for push instructions, when we want to push the data and to stop, we will write the instruction as push space the source, and when we want to take get the data out of the stack, we will write second instruction POP, pop space destination. The source and destination can be here any of the memory locations or registers. And we have third set of instructions where these instructions will come under the exchange category. That means, so exchange category, and here the mnemonics that we will use is XCH and XCHD. So when we write instruction, the general format of the exchange instruction will be XCH or XCHD. XCH space destination comma source. So when this instruction is executed by the controller, what it will do means whatever the data that is at the source will be copied to destination, and whatever the data that is there at destination will be copied to source location. So here destination source are the locations. That means this contains one data, this contains one data. The data in this is copied to this destination location. Destination location data is copied to source location. So here it is the exchange, not simple copy, right? So these are the three set or the three types of data transfer instruction. So we'll move on to discuss the each of the individual data transfer instructions and their functions with an example. So here we go with the first set of instructions. Where these instructions transfer or the copy the data from either accumulator to 8-bit register or from 8-bit register to accumulator. So that means, so first instruction that we go with is MOV space A comma RN, move A comma RN. So simply this is not the English word MOVE, but it is MOV, which is a mnemonic, which represents the opcode for the instruction, and A comma RN represents the operand part. The opcode MOV here indicates and specifies the operation to be performed, that is copy, copy operation. And what A comma RN indicate or specify to the microcontroller, that the data that we have to use for this copy operation is present in the two registers A and Rn. So what is the function performed by the controller when it executes this instruction? So what it will do? It will copy the content source. So this is source location Rn and this is destination location, that is register A. So the contents of the source location, that is Rn, are copied to the destination location, that is register A, R accumulator. So this operation we can indicate symbolically by in this way. That is, so here Rn, we have used the brackets here, that is, which shows that the brackets indicate the content of Rn. So for any register or memory location, if we write the brackets, then it indicates, we have to read it as content of the Rn. So whatever that is present in the Rn register will be copied to the register A. So here we go with the example, that means one example here we have indicated it as Rn, but there is no register with the name Rn. So here Rn specifies any of the registers R0, R1, R2, R3, R4, R5, R6, R7, any of the registers. So here we write one example. Move A, R2. So here the contents of the register R2 are copied to the register A. So whatever that is there in R2 before this instruction is executed is copied to the accumulator register, R register A. So you can see this we explained by using a very small table which indicates what are the contents of the register A and register R2 before this instruction is executed and after this instruction is executed. So here you can see that this is the column that indicates the before execution. So before execution, what is the content of A? XX. That means anything, any data. Okay? XX here means any data. Whatever may be the previous data, that we don't care actually. Okay, so there can be any data. So XX means there can be any data that we do not care. Okay, so you can see that before execution A contains some data. Okay, and you can see that before execution R2 contains, or the contents of R2 is 75H. Okay, so after execution what should happen? Whatever there is in the R2 is to be copied into accumulator. So R2 lo edaithe undo adi accumulator loki copy kavali. So after execution, before execution what is there in R2? 75H. After execution what should be there in accumulator? Whatever is there in R2 must be copied to accumulator. So after execution, accumulators should contain 75H. Then after execution, what should be the content of R2? See, already we have said that for the data transfer instruction, the contents of the source location remains unchanged. So previously R2 lo 75H undi, ade 75H untundi because the contents of R2, this is source location, remains unchanged. Only the data that is there in the source location is copied to destination location. Now the contents of R2 are copied to accumulator. And you can see that before and after execution, the contents of R2, which is source location, remain same. But before and after execution, the contents of the accumulator, which is the destination location, changes. So just go through this instruction and its function very clearly before we are going for a new instruction. So what it is doing actually, move A comma Rn means A comma Rn means the data is copied from an 8 bit register Rn to the accumulator. So where Rn is the destination source location and A is the destination location. So we indicate this in symbolic this way and we write an example by taking the R2 register, move A comma R2. So whatever there in the R2 before execution, which is 75H, is copied to accumulator after execution. That becomes the content of accumulator will be same as R2. So next we have another instruction, move Rn comma A. So here it is the reverse case, that is the content of the accumulator is copied to the register Rn, just opposite to the first operation. So that source and destination are interchanged when compared to the first instruction. It is same way, the accumulator contents are copied to Rn register. So here we go with an example, move R3 comma A. So here accumulator is the source location and R3 is the destination location. See here, location means it is the provision to store something, right? And here they are the registers and that's why we have written the register names, right? So here you can see that what is there in accumulator and R3 before execution. Accumulator has 75H and R3 has 56H. It is the data that is present in accumulator and register R3 before execution. And what should be the content of the accumulator and R3 after execution? You can see the accumulator is a source location, so its contents remain unchanged before and after execution. And R3 is the destination. So that means the content of A must be copied to R3. So the content of A must be copied to R3 after execution. So the content of R3 after execution will be 75H. Next we have one more instruction. You can see that XCH A comma Rn. And here you can see that we have a different mnemonic, that is XCH. So the mnemonic specifies the operation of exchange data bytes. So XCH is the mnemonic which specifies the operation of exchange the data bytes. So where the data bytes are present, that are present, that are specified by the operand part, they are present in the accumulator and Rn. So that is exchange the data bytes of present in register Rn and A. So this symbolically can be represented this way, the content of A and content of Rn are exchanged. So if you write an example instruction, you can write in this way, XCH space A comma R5. That is exchange the contents of A and R5. So we'll take an example and we'll see what happens before execution and after execution. So assume that the contents of A are 75H before execution and the contents of R5 are A8H before execution. So these are the contents of the accumulator and R5 before execution of this instruction. And what happens when this instruction is executed, that is after execution, whatever that is there in accumulator will be copied to R5 and whatever that is there in the R5 is copied to accumulator. So the data is exchanged. You can see after execution the data is exchanged. Okay. So this is what the function performed by a microcontroller when it executes this instruction XCH A comma Rn. Yes, then we have learned three instructions so far. It is which are used to move the copy the data between accumulator and 8-bit registers. So if you want to transfer the data from 8-bit registers Rn to accumulator, you are using move A,Rn. And if you want to transfer the copy the data from accumulator to any of these 8-bit registers, you are using move Rn, A. And if you want to exchange the data between the accumulator and any of these 8-bit registers Rn, you are using the instruction XCH A,Rn. So next we'll see. So if somebody asks you to write instructions for the following operation, so then how we are going to write? So here is asking to write instruction. First one is to write instruction to transfer the contents of register R2 to register R3. So that means he's asking us to write the instruction which performs the operation of transferring the contents of register R2 to register R3. And whatever that is there in R2 must be copied to register R3. So here what I can say, that what is source location? First this I have to identify. What is source location? It is your R2. From where you are copying the data, right? And what is your destination location? What is your destination location? It is your R3. And you want to copy the data from one register to 8-bit register to other 8-bit register. And if you can see that you cannot directly transfer the data from one location to one 8-bit register to other 8-bit registers. You can see here, see there is a data copy from accumulator to 8-bit or 8-bit to accumulator, but there is no copy of data from one 8-bit to other 8-bit. Like, so what we required is, we require is to transfer the copy the data from one 8-bit register R2 to another 8-bit register R3. But there is no such instruction directly. There is no such instruction directly. As you can see here also, we don't have any data transfer instructions which copy directly between two 8-bit registers. You can see here. You can see here. It is from accumulator to 8-bit or 8-bit to accumulator, register to memory location, memory to location to register. This is immediate data to registers or memory location. This is accumulator to memory location or memory location to accumulator. This is between two internal memory location. But there is no instruction directly to copy between two 8-bit registers. But you can see that what we require is, we have to copy from R2 to R3, which are again two 8-bit registers. So rendu 8-bit registers madhyalo data transfer, data copy cheyadaniki, we don't have an instruction directly. So what we can do is, we copy data from R2 to accumulator first. We copy R2 to accumulator first. So this is the first operation that we perform, and second operation that we want to perform is, so whatever that is there in R2 is copied to accumulator. But what we require, we don't require, we are not asked to copy from R2 to accumulator. We are asked to copy from R2 to R3. Since we don't have an instruction to copy R2 to R3 directly, what we are doing, we are copying the data from R2 to accumulator first, and then next we'll copy the data from accumulator to R3. So R2 నుంచి R3 కి డైరెక్ట్ గా కాపీ చేసే ఇన్స్ట్రక్షన్ లేదు కాబట్టి వాట్ వి ఆర్ డూయింగ్ వి ఆర్ యూజింగ్ దీస్ ఇన్స్ట్రక్షన్స్ వేర్ వి కెన్ కాపీ ఫ్రమ్ ఎనీ ఆఫ్ R రిజిస్టర్స్ టు అక్యుములేటర్ R అక్యుములేటర్ టు R రిజిస్టర్స్ సో దీస్ టు ఇన్స్ట్రక్షన్ విల్ బి మేకింగ్ యూజ్ to achieve this operation of copying contents of R2 into R3. So first we are copying R2 into accumulator, and whatever there in the accumulator is copied to R3. So finally it becomes copying equivalent to copying R2 contents into R3 itself. Okay, so this is the how we can transfer the contents of R2 to R3. So for this we are actually asked to write instructions. So this is the action that we do, the operation that is required. For these operations we have to write instructions. So for this first operation I will write the instruction. The instruction will be MOV. What is that? This is the source location, this is destination location. So MOV A, R2, that is the instruction. And for this operation, what is the instruction you can write? Move R3, A. And if these two instructions are executed, R2, content of R2 is copied to R3. First it is copied to accumulator and then it's to R3. So these two instructions will achieve the required task. And next we have one more operation for which we are required to write instructions. What is that? Transfer the contents of register A to the register R0. So this is very simple. This is very simple. Since it is asking to copy the data from accumulator to one of the 8-bit registers, copying the data from accumulator to one of the 8-bit registers, so you can use this instruction directly, move RN, A, where here our RN is MOV R0, A. So this is how we write instructions for the various operations. So we have learned three instructions here, and for that we have taken two examples and illustrated how the data transfer can be done. Thank you.